Welcome to Liftoff, your first place where you find everything space, and often SpaceX, while a separate team closes on the completion of a new and improved Starship Nosecone. SpaceX also appears to have begun assembling upgraded tank domes that feature a similar underlying design change. On the Nosecone front, SpaceX has been working on a new and improved version of Starship's Nosecone for at least a year, and assembling pathfinders and prototypes of varying fidelity since mid-2020. Around the same time when Starship SN15 became the first and only prototype to successfully launch and land further down the rocket, hints of Starship dome upgrades are a much more recent development. Including Starship Mk1, which never had its far flimsier nose fully installed, the Starship nose design has been extremely consistent ever since SpaceX began building the first prototypes in mid-2020. Early prototypes were inevitably scrapped as SpaceX quickly iterated on the nose design and assembly process, culminating in Starship SN8, which became the first prototype to have its basic structure, tank section, nose and flaps fully assembled. Though improvements and changes have almost certainly been made in the last 18 months or so, the early unflown prototypes and the noses of Starships SN8, SN9, SN10, SN11, SN15, SN16, SN20, and S22 have all been constructed in roughly the same way. SpaceX would first produce a series of thin, stamped sheets of steel. Once aligned on custom-built jigs, each one of these gores would be welded together to form a slightly conical ring. Five total rings would be assembled, each narrower and more conical than the last. The five sections would then be stacked one by one and welded together along their circumferences. Although something like 120 complex vertical wheels would be needed just to assemble the most basic structure of the nose, followed by 4 or 5 no less complex circumferential welds to turn those sections into one cone, SpaceX's upgraded design seeks to simplify that process mainly by increasing the size of the gores. Aside from modestly reducing the number of longitudinal sections needed to form the cone, SpaceX has already reduced the number of stacked sections from 5 to 2, slashing the total number of gores needed by at least a factor of 2 or 3. While not quite as substantial, the same simplifications also reduce the length and circumferential welds needed to assemble a cone. The spirit behind SpaceX's new dome design appears to be very similar, presumably doubling down on the stretch-forming production method developed for nose cone gores. SpaceX appears to have also decided to increase the size of dome gores and reduce the number of stacked sections required for dome assembly, albeit from 3 to 2 instead of from 5 to 2. Collectively, this behavior is mostly predictable. With increasing confidence in the current design of Starship and Super Heavy, SpaceX now appears to be looking for ways to streamline and simplify manufacturing while simultaneously optimizing Starship's design. Regardless of whether one of the dealings with a highly advanced rocket factory or a smartphone assembly line, part count reduction is very common and desirable to reduce both cost and complexity. Additionally, drastically reducing the number of individual welds and, to a slightly lesser degree, the total length of welds required should also reduce the number of possible points of failure and the time needed for weld inspection and repair. Having already scrapped a number of new nose pathfinders, it appears that Starship S24 will be the first to feature the new design. The process of stacking the ship has already begun. For domes, SpaceX appears to have only just begun assembling the first prototypes. If past dome changes are indicative of future behavior, one or several new test tanks will likely be built to ensure that the new dome design performs as well as present-day hardware. It's also unclear if SpaceX aims to replace all domes with a more spherical design, or if, say, current Starships and Super Heavy thrust domes will remain the same for the time being. SpaceX had its busiest month yet in April in terms of launches and the company's emphasis on the value of high flight rates. A Falcon 9 lifted off from Cape Canaveral's Space Launch Complex 40 at 5:27 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on April 29th, carrying a payload of 53 Starlink satellites. SpaceX confirmed the successful deployment of the satellites an hour after liftoff. The rocket's first stage landed on a drone ship in the Atlantic Ocean, completing its sixth flight. The booster was last used just 3 weeks on the launch of a Crew Dragon on the X-1 private astronaut mission to the International Space Station, a 21-day turnaround that was the shortest between flights to date. That launch was the sixth by SpaceX in April, the most by the company in any single calendar month. The company has performed 4 launches in a month several times and 5 in December 2021. SpaceX has conducted 17 Falcon 9 launches so far this year, keeping the company on pace to meet the goal of 1 launch a week this year. Flight rate is really, really important, Benji Reed, Senior Director of Human Spaceflight Programs at SpaceX, said during a panel discussion at the AIAA AscendX Texas conference on April 28th. Flight rate lets you learn. It lets you grow. You have to fly it correctly. You have to fly it safely. A key factor in the high flight rate is the company's own Starlink constellation. While only 2 of the 6 launches in April were of Starlink satellites, the others were the X-1 and Crew 4 crewed missions, the Transporter 4 rideshare mission, and the NROL-85 classified mission for the National Reconnaissance Office. 10 of the 17 Falcon 9 launches so far this year have been for the deployment of the broadband constellation. The Starlink launches, Reed says, are important for such things as pushing the limits of reusability. It allows us to really learn and expand the envelope of what it takes to fly at a very high flight rate, he said. This is the kind of flight rate that we need to be thinking about as an industry, he added. We should all look forward to the day, soon, when we are launching every day, every hour, every minute. Starship environmental delay. While SpaceX steps up its launch cadence, its Starship program remains marred in delays. The Federal Aviation Administration announced on April 29th that it was again pushing back the deadline for the completion of an environmental assessment for orbital launches of that vehicle from SpaceX's Boca Chica, Texas test site. The new deadline is now May 31st, a 1 month delay. And that concludes today's episode. Make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so you can keep updated with everything space and everything SpaceX. See you next time.